Hello and assalamu alaikum viewers. I hope you are fine and safe. I welcome back you all to my channel with another new video. I request that you please watch this video till the end. Today is a math session and today's topic is factors, multiples and prime numbers. But before we move any further, I would like to request you to please watch this video till the end, and if you are a new viewer then please subscribe to this channel, and if you have subscribed already then don't forget to share this video with your friends and family so that the knowledge spreads with as many people as possible. Also do leave a comment in the comment section below. Stay home, stay safe and keep learning. Today's video is learning objectives. In this video, we will be learning or revising what are factors, how to find out factors of a number, what are multiples, what are prime numbers, and how to identify prime numbers. First topic is what are factors. So, a number which can be exactly divided by another number, that is, leaving the remainder as zero, is called its factor. For example, 3 is the factor of 12 because when we divide 3 by 12, it gives us the quotient 4 and the remainder is 0. So from the example, we conclude that 3 is a factor of 12 because it does not leave any remainder when dividing 12. Another key point to remember is that when we multiply two numbers, the numbers being multiplied are actually the factors of the product, which is the answer. Example of this is here, which is 2 times 4 is 8. So here 2 and 4 can be called the factors of 8 because in division when we divide 2 or 4 by 8, it always gives us the remainder of 0. I can show you an example here. 8 and 2. Here we'll get 4 as the quotient and we'll be subtracting 8 and we'll be left with the remainder 0, which is what we need to consider something as a factor. Next, we'll be checking with 4. 8 divided by 4, which will give us 4 times 2 is 8. So 8 minus 8 will give us the remainder of 0. So now we conclude that 2 and 4 both are the factors of 8 and that this and also this sentence or statement can be considered true because we have proved it with this example. There are two main ways of finding the factors of a number. The first one being using division and the second one being using multiplication. Well, both of them require division, but we have to categorize them as two so that we are giving them different attributes. Now, first using division. Now, as you know, we have told earlier that a factor of a number is completely divisible by that number, which means that it leaves a remainder of 0. So we can conclude that it is a process of division. Yes, I here give you a tip, which is 1 is the factor of every number, whether it is 2 or 100 or any other number. 1 is always the factor because 1 is completely divisible by every number because every number comes in 1's table. So let's move on to the process. First, you'll have to look at the number. Is it even or is it odd? This is important so as to know which numbers you have to check for divisibility. Now, first, if it's even, then you'll have to check all numbers for divisibility until the half of that number. For example, if you take 32 as the number for finding the factors, then so it's even. So you'll need to check all numbers till the half of 32, which is 16, for divisibility, which means that do these numbers divide exactly by 32. So you'll have to check all numbers from 2 to 16 because 1 is already considered the factor and 32 will always be the factor. So you'll have to consider 2 to 16 for divisibility. Next, if the number is odd, you'll have to only check odd numbers for divisibility. Now, why I'm saying that for evens, you'll have to check all the numbers till the half, and for odd, you'll have to check only the odd numbers till the half for divisibility. That is because odd numbers can have even numbers as products when multiplied. For example, if you take 3 as the odd number, 3 times 2 is 6. So 3 here is the odd number and 6 here is the even number. So we can conclude that in odd number tables, we also get even numbers as products. So that is why I'm telling you to check all numbers for even, because even numbers can also come in tables of odd numbers, whereas odd numbers can only come in tables of odd numbers, because even numbers products must be divisible by 2, and odd numbers are actually categorized different because they are not divisible by 2. So here is an example. You can see checking the factors of 10. Now here he has checked only 1, 2, and 5, because 1 and 10 are already considered the factors. Remember, the number itself and the number 1 are always considered the factors of a number. So here we'll have to start checking from 2. So in a 2's table, we'll get 10 as completely divisible as shown here. In 3's table, we'll not get it because in 3's table, we don't have 10. We have 9. So the remainder will be 1. In 4's table, we'll get 8 and the remainder will be 2. So we'll also cancel out 4. Then we'll move on to 5. And 5 is 10 is divisible by 5, so we'll also check in with 5. So 2 and 5 are considered as factors and 1 and 10 are already compulsory. So let's move on to the second method. The second method is using multiplication. I'll be explaining this method using example only. Now first, take a number, say 30, and find any one large factor of that number mentally or by division method, whatever you prefer. So here we say 6 as a larger factor because it's quite good. Next, we'll divide 30 by 6 and we'll get the equation here as, and we'll here get the equation as 30 divided by 6 equals 5. Now here we have to further factorize 6. Now we have to here further factorize 6 to gain all the factors of 30. Now here we factorize 6 and we get the factors 2 and 3, because when we have to check in with the division method here to find the factors, now we'll have to multiply these factors which we have just now found out, 2 and 3, with the quotient found in the division sum here, which is 5. So you only multiply 2 by 5 and 3 by 5 which will result in 10 and 15. So now here you'll have to note down all the numbers which you have found till now. First we found out 6, then we found 5, then we found 2, then we found 3, then we found 10 and 15. And as you know, 1 and 30 are compulsory. So this process of multiplication requires a bit more concentration and work. So I would recommend you use the division method, and if you feel difficulty with it, then you can use this method as a substitute. Now you will be noting this down, all the factors which you have found, and then you will be arranging them in the ascending order, and then these will be considered factors of 30, which will be 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and 10 and 15. Sorry for this line here, it was just a mistake. Let's move on. Now, important points for identifying factors. These are some important points which you need to keep in mind when finding factors of a specific number. Now, first, every number has at least two factors. Now, whether you find any other factors or not, you will always write two factors. For example, here we have got the number 31. The number 31 isn't divisible by any other number except for 1. So, we'll not be leaving the factors blank. We'll have to write them optimum or compulsory two factors, which is 1, which you know from before, and the number itself for which you have to find the factors. These will be considered factors always. Don't forget to write them, whether there are more factors or whether there are less factors. Remember in the last example, first we jotted down all the factors which we have found from division and multiplication, and then I wrote down the optimum factors, which are 1 and 30 on both the ends, so as to keep in mind that you have to write them. Next, every even number must have 2 as its factor. If you are working with an even number, then that number will always have 2 as its factor, because you know that all even numbers are divisible by 2, so it is optimum to know that all even numbers will have 2 as their factor. Factors can only be positive whole numbers, meaning to say that they can't be fractions, decimals, or negative numbers. And remember, fractions are in this form. Decimals contain a point in between, like this, 3.8. And negative numbers have a minus sign. Whereas positive numbers are written as normal numbers like 2, 5, 10, 100, or any positive number which you have. Every number ending in 5 must have 5 as its factor, because you know that the rule of the tables that every number ending in a 0 or 5 will have 5 as its factor. So here we also have to keep in mind that every number ending in 0 or 5 must have 5 as its factor. Now every even number ending in 0 must have 2, 5 and 10 as its factors, because any number that ends in 0 except for the number 0 itself will have 2 as its factor, because it will be even, as 0 is considered an even number. Next, 5, because you know in division we have studied that any number that ends in 0 or 5 has 5 as factor. And 10, because we have also studied this in division, that every number ending in 0 must have 10 as its factor. Let's move on to multiples, our next topic. Now multiples are very simple as compared to factors. Simply said, a multiple of a number is the product of the number multiplied by a whole number. They are initially introduced in the mathematics tables, in the multiplication tables which you learn in primary school, where you study like this, 3 times 2 is 6, and here the products are the multiples of the numbers being multiplied. You can say that the factors and multiples are somehow interlinked, because the numbers being multiplied are actually the factors of the multiple product. Now here, an example to clear it out is that the product here is the multiple of 7 and 8. So simply said, whenever a number, two numbers are multiplied, the product will be the multiple of those two numbers being multiplied. And here, the correlation of factors and multiples also comes to life, that 7 and 8 are the factors of 56. Now let's move on. I guess you might have understood multiples and factors up till now. If you haven't understood, then please type in the comments if you have any question regarding this. Let's move on to prime numbers. Prime numbers are simply said numbers which have only two factors, which are the optimum factors, 1 and the number itself, and no other factor at all, whether it is 2 or anything. Now you know the definition of prime numbers, and I here will give you an example, such as 7. Here 7 is indivisible by any number. We can't divide 7 by 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. So here we can consider 7 as a prime. Yep, we'll be considering 7 as a prime. Sorry for this. Because it has only two factors, 1 and 7, which are necessary for a number to have. Now, let's move on. Numbers which have more than two factors, which means that any other factor except for 1 and the number itself, are called composite numbers. So composite numbers and prime numbers have a very huge difference. Prime numbers are numbers which have only two factors, 1 and the number itself, and composite numbers must have any other factor except for the two optimum factors. Now 2 is the only even prime number. All other even numbers are composite because they at least have 2 as their factor apart from 1 and itself, because as we know that all even numbers are divisible by 2. So this rule also applies. Now the numbers 1 and 0 are neither prime nor composites, because 0 has only 0 and 1 have only one factor, which is 0. 1 has only one factor, which is 1, and 0 has only one factor, which is 0. So they can neither be considered as prime, because prime numbers have the rule that it must have at least two factors, and composite says that the factors must be more than 2. So 1 and 0 go in neither category, so they are considered neither prime nor composite. So lonely. Now negative numbers, decimals and fractions cannot be categorized into primes or composites, because as you know, we can't find factors of negative numbers, decimals and fractions. So we also can't determine them as primes or composites, because categorizing a number as prime or composite requires finding the factors first, which can be done with decimals, negatives or fractions. Now let's move on to how to determine prime numbers. Now there are three ways First, prime numbers can simply be determined by trying to find any possible factors apart from one and the number itself, but failing to do so. So, if you are trying to find if a number is prime or composite, you just have to find if there are any other factors except for one and the number itself, and you fail to do so. So, if you fail to do so, it will be considered as prime, and if you succeed, then it will be considered as composite. Now, another method is to learn primes, obviously by heart, till 100 or 1000, so as to ease up a little. Because in school exams or anything like that, you can get something like that, something more than 1000, if you have learned 1000, and or a number more than 100 if you have learned 100. Lastly, you can use the prime factorization method, which will be covered in our next video. In the prime factorization method, if you fail to find any other factor except for the number 1 and the itself, you can call the number as prime. Now, today I'm going to tell you an interesting fact. About prime numbers, as you know, in the digital world, card numbers or bank receipts or anything like that are sent in encrypted format. Means they are encrypted in a way such that hackers or snoopers can't steal into them. So, for the encryption method, some mathematician and scientists developed a theorem, a very complex theorem for encryption, which was composed of numbers, and the numbers were actually prime numbers. So larger prime numbers are very, very, very hard to determine. So that makes it so good in encryption that the most advanced computers may also take years to crack the theorem, and that's quite a huge time for someone to try to hack or steal a card number. Okay, so that was all for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to leave a comment and share this video with your friends and family. Bye for now, and see you in our next video.